Good morning. I'm Michael Green, the counter jockey. This is Morning Gaming. How are you guys doing this morning? I'm trying something a little new. I'm going away from the me in the screen this week to see how it looks. So I'm going to do the intro like this, and then I'm going to cut to the game. That way, instead of me just like in the corner taking up UI space and detracting from the game, you'll just get me at the beginning. Though if you do want to see more of my bland, generic face, you can watch me on The Cheapest Seat, my wrestling show. Please watch it. Please watch it. I need more. So, without further ado, let's get to the further adventures of Randolph, the asshole Argonian.
Jimmy doesn't get cookies cause he's been bad. Now he's grounded to his room and he feels sad. Jimmy's daddy is downstairs and he's real mad, because Jimmy's normally been a real good lad!
How you guys doing this morning? Oh, I'm feeling pretty good. We had an 89 degree day, and then we had a day that was like 69 to like 76. You know, the temperature fluctuated because of the sun. For behind the scenes, that was the day I went to go cheer on my wife's best friend at the Boston Marathon. But it's been like very, in that true New Hampshire way, very fluctuating weights. Fuck, looking at all the weights of the items and getting thought jammed. That's probably a good way to put it. Take all these arrows. No, it's not what I want. God dang it. What did I just pick up? What? Yeah. What did I pick? Ah! Yeah. Don't need that. Pretty heavy for the weight. God bless my brain. It's yeah. Oh, I should have eaten breakfast before this. Instead, I'm just rolling in like a, like I'm drunk. I'm very, very drunk. No. I think my problem is when I'm doing something on screen and my brain naturally does what it normally does when I game. It detaches in a way from the gameplay and starts processing everything else that it can think about. So, like, I wasn't thinking about Skyrim there. I was thinking about, like, production stuff I need to do, what other filming I need to do. It's part of the reason why I'm checking out changing the format of this show is, A, I think it brings a little bit something, you know, it removes a little bit of screen clutter. Personally, I think at the moment, with it just being me, it's not that interesting to just sit there and focus on, hey, what's this asshole doing? What time is it? Well, he has to leave. Wait, what the fuck time is it? Oh. Why is the door unlocked? But yeah. Besides making the screen look a little nicer during the episode,
I don't claim looking to protect yourself or deal some damage.
It's a lot cleaner to edit because normally I have to like sync up the video of me with the audio I take from my microphone, because OBS is amazing at noise reduction.
I have no idea what voodoo I have set up at the moment. It's just the best. Well, that doesn't carry over if, say, I plug the mic directly into my camera. So, one of the things I need to look at getting is a I want to get a boom mic for recording things like the cheapest seat. But for now, I've got what I've got. So, you know, just kind of had to fiddle with things. Holy crap, I thought those were arrows when I originally looked at the, like, oh, I got this many of them. Oh. That would partially explain why I was overweight. Holy hell. Yeah, the beginning of this episode is going to be me hawking this stuff and then fast traveling back and looting some more of those corpses.
Watch what you're... Everything's for... Take a look.
I mean, we got houses to buy later. This is... The unfortunate side effect of a game like this. I think I'm going to hold out for something better than a steel dagger. Right now I've got this orcish sword. I don't have backstab yet. I think it's what we need to go for. Also, we can sell. Just sell things. Just sell it. Get rid of it. What do you got? Maybe hold on to the gemstones for a hot second there. Need to learn that.
Some may call this junk. Me,
okay.
I call
accidentally
treasure.
Clicked slightly outside of the little area. Instantly closed the trade. Okay. Let's read this book. Also, let's get a drink.
Come back.
Had the bedroom window open because of the just general temperature unpredictability, so the chaos that has been the weather. We left the window open, and with it getting like 40 degrees when I woke up, the air like dried out a lot. So I think I'm gonna, like, it's gonna take me drinking water all day to have my mouth and throat not feel like a desert. And wouldn't you know it, it sparked one of my least favorite aspects of my body. I don't know how many of you guys fight with dandruff. That shit is insidious. It's like, oh, you know, it's just like a little thing. No. See, the conditions are just right. Oh, this could be difficult. Oh. It's just a nightmare. Gotcha. Take that. These are mine. That's neat. But yeah. And that totally wasn't the reason for getting rid of the camera. Hell, if I was gonna have the camera, it'd be right now, where I'm actually I'm dressed nicer than I normally would for a regular day. I just decided, you know, I'd actually, you know, dress a little bit up for just a random, what's today, Wednesday? I know for you guys it's a Monday, for me it's a Wednesday. Well, we looted all these fools. If the game were a little bit more dynamic with things you could do, I'd pile up all the bodies and burn them. But we're not able to do that, so I just have to leave them and help contribute to the wolf problem. Because that's how you get wolves. Let's go say hi to Ulfric. So Ulfric learned a shout, which tells me a couple things.
Oh, I do the cooking and cleaning around the palace.
That's neat. That means that he had to learn he had to learn from one of the Dragonstone, like one of those like shrines.
Folks are finding victory across the land.
And then he had to get like a dragon soul, or he's been studying it for decades.
The Imperials have really dug into Whiterun. We're wrested from them soon enough. We must. Its central position is key. Damn him. That old bear was right. Did you run into any trouble?
Yes, all of it.
Damn it. What were they doing there? Imperial spies are everywhere. Never forget that. I trust you gave them a thrashing. Now then, I'm glad you're here. I have a message I need delivered to the Jarl of Whiterun. Deliver this axe to Balgruuf the Greater.
Yes, an axe. How long have you been in Skyrim? Give the man my axe.
If he keeps it, I will bide my time. If he returns it to you, it means war. Men who understand each other often have no need for words. There are but a few simple truths behind one warrior giving another his axe. Balgruuf will know my meaning. Keep your wits about you.
I don't think I ever really paid attention to this quest chain. I also probably got, I don't know, 300 hours of gameplay out of this game before I ever picked a side. So that's probably got a lot to do with it. But that would explain why they give you an axe when you become a Thane of Whiterun. Don't want to do that right now. I wonder if you do this mission even if you... You know what? I'm curious now. I guess spoilers for Skyrim. But the way you normally start the game out is you go to Bleak Falls Barrow and get that Dragonstone, which you can do before you go to Whiterun. But I've never done it where I just get both parts of that and go do something like this, which will change the upper management of Whiterun. I probably should have sold my shit here. Don't care. Okay.
I try to...
Map. I think my brain's too just in go mode this morning. Oh, okay. Certain games, you need to do something in between to break up your mindset. Because I've been playing Breath of the Wild, and oh boy, I almost just tried to jump off that glide.
Terrible and powerful Talon. We, your unworthy servants,
that being said, though, that game is a delight to play. Like, I hit upon the perfect description of that game the other day. It is as if the people making the Zelda game sat down and played way too much Dark Souls and played way too much Shadow of the Colossus and ended up with something that has design ideologies from both. Also the aesthetic of them.
Got a lot of steel to shape. Gods be praised.
Like, I mean, Zelda, though, has always kind of had a surviving the apocalypse theme, I guess. If you look at... Ocarina of Time. Ocarina of Time is, hey, you're like the chosen one. You're the kid that can travel backwards and forwards through time, and because you travel forward in time, you miss the apocalypse. You're not there when it happens to everyone else. And so you have to use the fact that you can go forward in time to go find a bunch of the things that you then need in the past to try and thwart what's happening. You know, very, very much you missed the end times, as it were.
Here, I'd like you to have this as a token of my friendship.
Oh, thank you.
Random
clothes.
I work with my mother, sell fruits and vegetables.
It's not weird or anything. But, I mean, Majora's Mask is literally... The moon is going to hit the planet in this many days.
That sort of thing.
I don't need that. So, they hit that really well with the plot of Breath of the Wild.
Do come back.
Not to get too deep into the story, but something you find out right away in the game, right at the very beginning, is it's taking place 100 years after you failed to fight Ganon. This is the Zelda game that starts after Zelda and Link fail to defeat Ganon. And what that means for Hyrule, what it means for the individual characters involved. And amnesia stories are a super tired trope, but the way they use regaining those memories as a storytelling device and as a mechanic, it's so good.
Mister, could you spare a coin?
Not right now. I'm busy doing, like, war diplomacy, I guess. If I could just stop picking flowers. I'm just addicted to picking flowers, though. Like, yeah, no, he's a really great fighter, and, like, you know, he can get in and out of all these places that we just did not expect, but he does spend a lot of time just frolicking around picking flowers. We've talked to him about it, we can't figure it out. I should probably also be, doing that as well. Can you open the door? Could you please? What's the past tense of the act of doing diplomacy?
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
Did he now?
The man is persistent, I'll give him that. But until that dragon's dealt with, Ulfric's just going to have to wait. For now, I'll hold on to this axe, but it's a tenuous piece at best. Now, I believe you have some business to conclude with my court wizard.
Okay, so the game does not let you sequence break. So if I want to continue my story of helping the Stormcloaks, I have to first do this story. Fair. Oh, come on. There we go. Kind of wish I'd kept the robes just for doing this bit. Oh, well. Oh, why did I think I could make that jump? Oh, but I did find more flowers I hadn't picked. I'm gonna look up and have like 100 pounds of flowers and have to like sell a bunch of these off to just be able to walk around.
Maybe some other time I'll reveal your destiny.
Come on. Well, how much do I got here? I got 7 more iron ore and 1 silver. So 15 more casts. Activate fast motion. Ah, there we go. That wasn't ridiculous or anything. Okay, let's make some gold. Okay. Now what can we make with that gold? Let's look at some jewelry. So all the gemstones I have are the wrong kinds. Well, I guess flawless. Bonehawk skull, bonehawk feathers. Huh. Okay. Keep that in mind. So that's... This is better value... because you get 2 gold rings per ingot. And it comes out to slightly more value. So. If I'm going to increase my smithing at all, that's the way I'm going to do it. Let's see. What do we got? We leveled up in there. What do you think? We hit stamina of 200. Let's try that. Chanting, smithing, heavy armor. Don't care. Block is, yeah, I have to wait a while to block again. One-handed weapon. That got the power attack thing. I haven't put any points in archery, but it has been important. It's gotta be still. I feel like pickpocket could be really useful if we ever used it. Speech is also a good one. And alchemy is also a really good one. Alchemy is one of those where, like, this is super helpful if you're going to be, like, sneaking into places and attacking people. I want to put the points into both into all of them, archery, sneak, and alchemy, because a combination of those and you could basically rule the world. I think, yeah, let's just go ahead and figure out our main paths. I think we're going to go alchemy. Speech is low priority, but alchemy, sneak, archery one-handed, and block our sneaky character has a shield, because hell yeah we do. I'm gonna end up fighting a whole bunch of dudes. So, let's start with the ability to fight. I've made the mistake in the past of doing the, I'll just work on my crafting first, and then I'll go fight. And then you go to fight stuff, and it's all level adjusted. Because here's a complaint I have. Your level is based on all of your different skills. Even though there are some that are, let's say, not combat applicable. And then there's some that are, they're not balanced the same way. I have a problem with that. let's go here first. It makes doing some stuff first dangerous. Give a holler if you have any questions. Let's see here.
I offer
damage, health is what? Nightshade, red mountain flower.
Do let me know if I can be of service.
Let's try some bunch of stuff that we've never tried with red mountain flower with it.
I sell cures for all ills, and I'll be happy to serve you.
I feel like something called Bleeding Crown should have been useful for that, but whatever. Why not? Oh, okay.
If there's anything I can help you with, you have but to ask.
Oh boy. The height of interesting gameplay, right? I tried setting here with one of the strategy guides and doing this once for a playthrough where I just took the strategy guide and looked at the types of stuff and went ahead and just did the matches that I needed to, and it was just, no. It was somehow duller than this. This, at least, you can kind of RP it as your character sitting here trying this shit. Eh. Nightshade? Yeah, I tried it with you. You? No? Okay. How about you? No? Okay. So that's everybody tried with everybody, so this is the stuff that I can just straight up make right now. So let's save Nightshade. That's Ravage. So that's damage, health. That's Fortify Magicka. What can I have? Nope. That's what I was talking about with, like, the stuff that you're just like, wow, that doesn't fit with anything. Your assault does not match with anything. Purple Mountain Flower? Sure. What else can Purple Mountain... That's it. Okay. That goes there and there. You'll find you don't go anywhere. Salves, poultices, and potions on my shelves. I only need 10 for the Nightshade.
sell cures for all ills, and I'll be happy to serve you.
Okay, and then this. My thinking on that was flawed, and I appreciate that I goofed there, but whatever. Take some poison, and I've just got like 6 pounds of purple mountain flower, 3 pounds of salt.
You'll find tonics. You look rather pale.
I want you to buy my stuff. Here. Those are mine. I have a feeling I don't need to carry all of this extra stuff. Like, 4% resistance to magic. I think I'll just suffer through. I'm keeping a potion of pickpocketing around because I have a feeling I'm not going to need that for the longest time, and then I'm going to suddenly need it. We have that. I think straight just buff to health, I'm just going to go ahead and sell. Also that one. 4 to 5 health that also heals me? Yeah, I'll do that one. Don't care about... Actually, you know what? I'm gonna try and sell odds and ends stuff. Oh! Didn't realize I'd made haggle potions. Probably should've used those. Destruction spells? Nope. Brief invisibility? Hell yeah. You know what? You can have these. That drains 40 points of magic. This one, though, is really good. Because that means even if they zap you once, they can't quite do it right away. They get one good shot, and then they have to sit around and wait.
Come back anytime if you need a remedy.
You got the remedy? The remedy? Sorry. Pardon me.
But do I detect a case of...
Got something for just about everybody in here. Give a holler.
Her dialogue always freaked me out because she asks you like, "Oh, do you look pale?" And I was just always just like, "Am I pale? Am I gonna die?" Turns out she's just neurotic. I'm like, "Oh, oh, you scared me." These aren't really that relevant to anything I want to make, so I'm just going to go ahead and sell them.
Do come back.
Well, let's go to Dragon's Reach because the mage there loves buying like jewelry and shit. I would like fast motion out me selling stuff,
I thought
but
you were already on your way to Bleakfall. What are you still doing here? The
spells
and
incantations
for those with the talent to guess them.
Yeah, so I would cut out this bit of me selling things, but I think it's enough a part of this experience that I'll keep it in. It's like, yeah, fighting and stuff is the stuff you come to Skyrim for, but this is part of it. And morning gaming is not about blowing smoke up your ass. We have shifted focus a bit. I think we should change the stone that we're aligned with to get a bonus to our thief skills. just going to go ahead and own that I was wrong initially. I know I wanted to be more of a fighterman. And I was wrong. Turns out I couldn't fight my very nature, which is to sneak in and shoot guys with a bow. Whoa!
Say, if a vampire watches scratches you, you'll turn into one. That better not be true.
Why, you get scratched? Show me.
Show me your arm!
Whatever. Not my village. Not my guard turning into a vampire. Just gonna loot all your stuff. And I'm also gonna sleep. Cause we haven't slept in a while, and that's probably bad.
Orgnar.
Probably going insane.
Are you listening?
We got rooms and food. Drink too. I cook. Ain't much else to tell.
Any rumors?
Lucan at the Riverwood Trader had his store broken into the other night. Oddly enough, barely anything's been stolen. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Have bounties are eventually.
Shrine of Azura?
I like the dark elves built it
after they fled from Morrowind. Sight to see. Word is, Ulfric Stormcloak escaped from the Imperials. War's only gonna get worse now. They say a dragon attacked Helgen. Sounds like hogwash to me.
I was there. It actually happened.
Hard not to.
Oh, but I came here to
talk to. We've got something of a love triangle here in Riverwood.
Ooh.
Faendal and Sven, both vying for Camilla's affections. All right, then.
Do you not sell the rooms? Do you sell the rooms? I'm
You're
sorry.
That visitor been poking around.
Yeah.
They say a dragon attacked Helgen. Sounds like hogwash to me.
Spoilers.
Sure, it's yours for a day.
Of everybody in Skyrim, it's kind of not hogwash to you.
Word is, Ulfric Stormcloak escaped from the Imperials.
Yep, ale's going
War's
bad.
Only going to get... I guess you don't have potatoes in your ears after all. Just make sure we get a fresh batch in soon.
That's not my bed. Someone next to it? Eh, it's my bed. We're gonna sleep for 10 hours. Like men. Wait. Oh, that's not good. Hi.
Sleep well.
Yeah. Who are you, Cookie Puss?
Does it matter? You're warm, dry, and still very much alive. That's more than can be said for old Grelod,
Yeah, because I killed her.
Half of Skyrim knows. Old hag gets butchered in her own orphanage. Things like that tend to get around. Oh, but don't misunderstand. I'm not criticizing. It was a good kill. Old Crone had it coming. And you saved a group of urchins to boot. But there is a slight... problem. You see, that little Aretino boy was looking for the Dark Brotherhood. For me and my associates. Grelod the Kind was, by all rights, a Dark Brotherhood contract. A kill that you stole. A kill you must repay.
Okay.
Well now, funny you should ask. If you turn around, you'll notice my guests. I've collected them from... Well, that's not really important. The here and now. That's what matters. You see, there's a contract out on one of them, and that person can't leave this room alive. But, oh, which one? Go on. See if you can figure it out. Make your choice. Make your kill. I just want to observe and admire. Am I to take your silence as acceptance? Then you know where we stand. Make your kill and we're square. Repayment of your debt is but a discreet knife thrust away.
Okay, so if one of them has a contract on them and they can't leave the room alive.
Whoever this is, clearly we got off on the wrong foot.
Then we can't let any of them live, because that would mean that we might... We have a 1/3 chance of getting them, but a 2/3 chance of letting them live. And that's bad. Just, like, murders the three people, and then immediately starts running around the room, just picking up everything that's not nailed down. Pardon me. I have a problem.
Well, well. Aren't we the overachiever? Three possibilities, three victims. Must have been one of them, right? So why take chances?
Exactly.
Indeed. For you, my friend, seem to understand what's truly important. When I give an order to spill blood, you follow it. No questions, no remorse. Of course. And you've repaid your debt in full. Here's the key to the shack. But why stop here? I say we take our relationship to the next level.
What is it with all of the double entendres
and
suggestive language in this game?
I would like to officially extend to you an invitation to join my family, the Dark Brotherhood. In the southwest reaches of Skyrim, in the Pine Forest, you'll find the entrance to our sanctuary. It's just beneath the road, hidden from view. When questioned by the Black Door, answer with the correct passphrase, "Silence, my brother." Then you're in, and your new life begins. I'll see you at home.
Well, how many job offers are we going to get in our first, like, month in Skyrim? Like, I've been here for only, well, it feels like a few weeks. And I've joined the Stormcloaks. I've joined the Thieves Guild of Riften. And now I'm joining the Dark Brotherhood. Well, I guess if I came to Skyrim to start my life over and really make something of myself, I am making leaps and bounds in that direction. Yep, the abandoned shack. What were we going to do? I was sleeping. Oh, I was sleeping because I was going to go to Bleak Falls Barrow. Wait, what? God dang it. I hate when this happens. You get this here, where, like, there's something. I think there's spiders over to that side. Nope, gotta remove that. I hate that it's left click to drop that, and there's no, like, choice to do it. It just does.
Trouble?
No trouble here.
Ain't every day we get visitors in Riverwood.
Just taking an armload of cabbages I found. Give me what's in this too. I think Randolph has a problem that has been made worse by joining the Thieves Guild.
No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what thief chasing? Are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
We are done talking about this. Oh, a customer. Sorry you had to hear that.
I think Randolph has impulse control problems, and they've gotten worse because he's being,
I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood Trader is still open.
Feel free to shop.
Cool.
Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
But yeah, his impulse control problems are getting worse because he's being, there's a word that I can't think of right now. Enabled. He's aligning himself with enablers that are just like, oh yeah, no, your bad habits, we can so make use of your bad habits. They're worth cash money to us. And he's just like, okay. Guy's just like, where did you get all of this random shit? I don't know. I found it. I'll keep this and sell someplace else. I need to read that. Oh, God.
Take a look.
Let's see. Potions. Ingredients. Probably sell like a pound and almost 2 pounds of that. Three and a half pounds of purple mountain flower. There we go.
Damn thief.
Yeah, let's get out of the place where the guy's screaming about thieves when I'm standing there.
I'm looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Wait, what?
Let's see here. Ah, there's a new lady in charge of the orphanage in Riften. She asked me to hand out these notices to everyone I met. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Is there an ancient Nordic god of delivering mail? Some sort of messenger god that's fucking with me personally? Okay. Let's take bets now. What's the time? What is my time in seconds from bridge to wolf? Because I don't remember if there's a wolf up here. But I feel like there's a wolf that's just going to attack me any second. God, I see you! The worst. The worst. No ecosystem can support this level of predation unless we are just bringing in boatloads of meat to feed you. It does not make sense. Unless bandits are an actual endless supply. That might make a little bit more sense. Oh, what do we got? Some bandits have taken up in that tower. When in doubt, assume they are bandits. Fuck, I've been playing Zelda. I don't know if my distance. Shit. Too far away to be moving around. There. Their vision is based on whatever the game feels like. Because, like, I'm standing here in, like, black and brown in a gray and white landscape. I should stick out like a sore thumb. But I don't somehow. That's right, go check on your friend. That's right. Okay, so from that distance, what the hell? Like, one was a headshot and one was a butt shot? The fuck is the drop off on these arrows? Oh! Wrist shot! Wow! Some good ass poison. All of your things. All of your things are now Randolph's. Knock, knock. Shit. Well, dance. Oh! Oh! What? Okay. Wow. I stabbed him right in his cutscene. That was brutal. Does that happen a lot when you use melee weapons? I honestly don't know. Most every playthrough, it's me with a bow, and if they get close enough that I can't bow them, I then set them on fire. That was rad. Oh, that's where I missed earlier. Hit the tree or the limb? I think I, like, caught the edge of the limb. How much weight are we carrying? We already have 200 pounds of stuff. I say we go over this hill and see if there are people. There are. And then we'll take that back to town. Okay. Oh, fuck. Was that a miss? A miss. Come on, butt climb. There we go. Oh, you just no-sold that. Hehe.
True Nords never back down.
Oh shit, he has a bow. Hey, that's racist. Oh, I guess that's how we deal with racists around here. Was there anyone else that just somehow missed the sound of him yelling racist shit and then dying? Also, there we go. Can I remember right there, there ain't shit on this side. I feel like we're missing a guy. Wait. That's a tough one. Where do you walk? Gonna make this. Oh, got him. Wow. Thought you'd go wider. Shit.
Tell you what. Start running. So I can stab you in the back.
Whew. I totally went way too wide on that one. Yet I got him here. That was a neat surprise. Can I fast travel to here? Yes, I can. How much money did I leave this guy with? I feel like I didn't leave him with shit for money. But there is another guy in town, so we'll go talk to him. I feel like all we've done this episode is, like, some mild diplomacy and selling things.
Did I see you talking to Sven? Maybe not. Maybe... Never mind. But I would stay away from him if I were you.
Oh, okay.
God might get nervous. A man approaches with his weapons.
Whatever you... Take a look.
I want to sell you stuff. Take my stuff. Don't mind the blood. I know it's just bathed in blood, but just try not to mind it too much. I leveled up from that. Because just selling indiscriminate amounts of stuff helps. Block is still too low to... I want that one. That's kind of neat. I don't know how much that's useful, but it's neat. Oh, I've already put a point in it. I can put it... Okay. Sneak. Can't actually put another point in sneak right now. Alchemy, I haven't put a single point in yet. But... Hell yeah. This is nice. This is really nice. That one is also super helpful for being efficient. This is one of the best end perks. If you go to make a potion, if you go to make a poison that would happen to give a healing effect, it just ignores it. Same with making a healing thing. You can just ignore. So, as long as whatever the primary goal is met, like health or damage, it does the appropriate side effects. So like it'll do, if there are multiple bad effects but you started with a primary poison, that's just nice. It's just nice. Says the guy who obviously needs to get some food in him. Power attack versus alchemy. I mean, I guess hitting people never goes out of fashion. Oh, no, that's just 1 point. It just shows white forever. Okay, that's kind of annoying. Well, then, we actually are putting this into alchemy.
Respect the law and you disrespect me.
Well, then fuck you. So, it sold enough stuff to not be completely weighted down. Let's go to Bleak Falls Barrow. Hi, my horse. But how did you get magical horse? I swear. This is why there are wolves. It just the wolves don't actually eat a lot of like rabbit, things like that. No, they just live on fucking dead bandits. And I'm adding to that problem. Maybe if I did some diplomacy, it would just make life better around here. Here. Watch me do this diplomacy. How do you not see me?
It's a thing. I cannot test you.
Yeah, shield slam me to death. If I could dual wield shields, I would. Don't think that I would. You guys like fought a bunch of rats. Probably should have cut a couple open, man. I found 2 gemstones from checking these rats. You're kind of bad at your job as bandits. Ooh. I got him like right in the hard to scratch place. Do you think for a moment his brain was like, oh man, that's gonna be annoying to like, that itch is going to be annoying to scratch. Like, as his eyes were actively rolling up into the back of his skull. Was he just like, hey, that sucks. Dead. Well, I guess we should take it. We'll sleep here for a bit and think about that. Because that's been it for morning gaming today. I'm Michael Green, the Counter Jockey. Go have a good day. Be productive. Look at Randolph. He's been productive. Like, buying and selling goods. I mean, he's been spending arrows to buy goods and then taking gold for those goods. And he basically has more arrows. He keeps gaining more arrows than he expends, so he just generates money. And wouldn't that be nice? Have fun, guys. And I'll see you next time.